After the war, I went back to New York.
After the war, I went back to New York.
I finished up my studies and I practiced law.
I practiced law, Burr worked next door.
Even though we started at the very same time, Alexander Hamilton began to climb. How to account for his rise to the top? Man, the man is non-stop.
Gentlemen of the jury, I'm curious, bear with me. Are you aware that we're making history? This is the first murder trial of our brand new nation. The liberty behind the liberation. I intend to prove beyond a shadow of a doubt with my assistant counsel.
Co-counsel Hamilton, sit down. A client, Lemmy Weeks, is innocent. Call your first witness, that's all you had to say.
Okay, one more thing.
Why do you assume you're the smartest in the room? Why do you assume you're the smartest in the room? Why do you assume you're the smartest in the room? Soon that attitude may be your doom.
Why do you write like you're running out of time?
Write day and night like you're running out of time.
Every day you fight like you're running out of time.
Keep on fighting in the meantime.
Non-stop.
Corruption's such an old song that we can sing along in harmony. And nowhere is it stronger than in Albany. These colonies, economies increasingly stalling. And honestly, that's why public service seems to be calling
non-stop.
I practiced the law, practically perfected it. I've seen injustice in the world and I've corrected it. Now for a strong central democracy. If not, then I'll be Socrates throwing verbal rocks at these mediocrities.
Hamilton at the Constitutional Convention.
I was chosen for the Constitutional Convention.
There is a New York junior delegate.
Now what I'm gonna say may sound indelicate.
He goes and proposes his own form of government.
What?
His own plan for a new form of government.
What?
Talks for 6 hours, the convention is listless.
Bright young man.
Yo, who the F is this?
Why do you always say what you believe?
Why do you always say what you believe?
Every proclamation guarantees free ammunition for your enemies.
Why do you write like it's going out of style? Write day and night like it's going out of style. Every day you fight like it's going out of style. Do what you do.
Alexander?
Aaron Burr, sir.
Well, it's the middle of the night.
Can we confer, sir?
Is this a legal matter?
Yes, and it's important to me.
What do you need?
Burr, you're a better lawyer than me.
Okay.
I know I talk too much. I'm abrasive. You're incredible in court. You're succinct, persuasive. My client needs a strong defense. You're the solution.
Who's your client?
The new U.S. Constitution?
No.
Hear me out.
No way.
A series of essays anonymously published defending the document to the public.
No one will read it.
I disagree.
And if it fails?
Burr, that's why we need it.
The Constitution's a mess.
So it needs amendments?
It's full of contradictions.
So is independence. We have to start somewhere.
No. No way.
You're making a mistake.
Good night.
Hey, what are you waiting for? What do you stall for?
What?
We won the war. What was it all for? Do you support this Constitution?
Of course.
Then defend it.
And what if you're backing the wrong horse?
Burr, we studied and we fought and we killed for the notion of a nation we now get to build. For once in your life, take a stand with pride. I don't understand how you stand to the side.
I'll keep all my plans close to my chest.
Accompanied by someone who always pays. I have found a wealthy husband who will keep me in comfort for all my days. He is not a lot of fun, but there's no one who can match you for turn of phrase. My Alexander,
Jacob.
Don't forget to write.